This remarkable piece of work revolves around the story of an FBI informer, Peter Coslow, working against a Polish gang. Peter is sent on a dangerous mission inside the Bale Hill prison, but FBI authorities betray him and leave him stranded there. Who is Peter Coslow? How does the FBI find him? What is the dangerous mission inside the jail? And what he does do to get out of there? Let's get into the video to find the answers to all these questions. Hello, and welcome to I Am Movies. The movie opens with an undercover agent, Peter Coslow, talking to an FBI agent on the phone about a meeting when he receives a call from a Russian drug dealer and his friend Stasik. Stasik confirms that they will receive 6 keys of fentanyl tomorrow, and he can draw his uncle's attention. Soon, Peter's daughter Anna awakens listening to his voice, and when she tells her father that they don't use bad words in their house,
you should tell him there's no bad words in our house.
He suggests waking up her mother, as she is going camping with her. In the meantime, he informs the FBI about tomorrow's meeting. After that, Peter's wife, Sophia, wakes up, and he tells her to get ready to leave the house. On the other hand, Agent Erica Wilcox contacts her boss, Officer Keith, and asks permission to act on their plan using Peter. The boss allows her, ensuring her credit for using Peter for the job. Erica arranges a meeting and teaches her men about the Polish gang named Wojtek and its leader, Klimek, also known as the General. She informs them they have an informant among the gang members and asks them to be gentle with him. After that, Wilcox meets Peter and gives him a phone, stating that she has saved her numbers with many names and will stay in touch with him. Then she gives him a recording device to keep with himself when he meets the General.
Right before you meet the General, they'll strip you of all electronics.
The next day, Peter and Stasik receive the drugs and deliver them to a specific location. Everything is going according to plan, but then Stasik stops the car at a liquor store to get a bottle for his uncle and reveals that he has found a buyer for their fentanyl. Peter and Erica, who are listening to their whole conversation, are stunned and hope Peter sticks to the plan. She contacts Keith and informs him about the buyer, but he orders her to follow Stasik and arrest the buyer before the deal is made, thus recovering the narcotics. After a while, Stasik brings a man inside Agnieszka Bar, and he claims to buy the whole fentanyl from them. As Stasik reveals that he has 6 keys, the man is confused and requests that Stasik give him time to arrange the money to buy 3 of them.
I'm good for 3, okay? Just give me a couple hours.
Peter observes the buyer and becomes suspicious of him. He starts investigating the people he has spent time with inside the Bale Hill jail and mentions the names that can't be followed. Stasik leaves after getting a call, and after he leaves, Peter recognizes that he is a cop and starts pushing him out of the bar for wasting his time. The man then reveals his identity by showing his badge and pointing his gun out. Peter tries to talk to him, but then Stasik shoots him from behind, and Peter and Erica are left shocked at the death of a cop. Peter becomes nervous and leaves the bar to hit a cigar when he spots Erica leaving. Stasik comes and orders him to help him get rid of the body. After that, Stasik and Peter arrive at Klemek's place to see him, and Peter gets scared of getting Stasik beaten by his uncle. Klemek talks to him politely and reveals that Peter is the best drug runner in the Wojtek.
The best drug runner in Wojtek.
And now the NYPD will be behind him for killing one of their men, which means bad business for him. He then mentions that he has been told that the cop had his gun pointed at Peter, for which he owes his life to Wojtek. Klimek questions him about the worth of his life and reveals that he needs him to return to Bale Hill Prison, as he has been there for 4 years already and can easily get fentanyl inside. Klimek tells him that he wants to supply drugs inside the jail as the prisoners will owe him inside and on the streets, which will help him have an army. Peter is confused and replies that it's not worth his life, but Klimek suggests he think of his family, revealing that he found Sophia and Anna traveling around their house. Peter is helpless, and as he returns home with Sophia and Anna, he contacts Erica and gets mad at him for not helping him out of there. Anna listens to her father and gets scared of him, but Sophia sends her out to play with her friend. After that, Peter argues with Sophia about not walking away and saving Anna.
Why didn't you protect Anna?
But she tells him that she kept waiting for him and hugs him. Later that night, Stasik and his men throw the cops in the city, and as the police find the dead body, Detective Edward Grenz comes to see his corpse and reveals the dead officer's name is Daniel Gomes. After that, he starts investigating where Daniel died and meets his friend, Catherine, at night. He tells her that he thinks Klimek and Wojtek are involved in Daniel's murder and shows her Peter's CCTV footage, in which he seems very nervous. Edward asks Catherine for her badge and catches Daniel's source girl. Edward tries to investigate the source strictly, but Catherine requests to let her handle it.
You want to be professional, let me do this, all right?
In the following scene, Peter meets Erica and gets mad at her for leaving him alone among Klimke and his gang. Suddenly, Keith joins them, and when Peter insists on getting free, he warns him that he is already in a lot of trouble. Erica suggests he follow Klimke's plan and return to the jail to provide them with the list containing the names of Klimke's suppliers. Peter questions what if he says no, and then Erica tells him they will have to send him back to jail to complete his 12-year sentence. Moreover, the NYPD may find him and stack their punishment for killing her man. Eventually, Peter has to agree to the job, and as he returns home, he listens to the tape recording of his conversation with Erica and Keith and stores it. Next, Edward meets Catherine, who informs him that she has found nothing on Stasek, but has found information about Peter. She adds that Peter was sentenced to 12 years in prison for killing a man in a bar fight.
20 years for killing a guy in a bar fight.
But after 4 years, he came out mysteriously, which makes him a suspicious man, as the feds may be involved. The next day, Stasek and his men arrive at Peter's house, and he leads them to the garage. Stasek tells him to get ready for jail and sort out how to get inside. He gives him a packet of drugs to use as parole and leaves, revealing that the general wants to visit him before he goes to jail. Sophia listens to their conversation, and after Stasek leaves, she is scared to learn that Peter is going to jail again. Peter spends the day with Anna and works on the jail's structure from a safe distance. Later that night, he meets Erica, who tells him about Wardenliner and tells him to hand over the list of names to him after he completes the job, and he will be out within 24 hours. Peter tells her three conditions. He wants a complete drug sweep after the job is done. He will be working in the program while he is in jail. She will deliver the drugs to him. Eric accepts the first two, but she tells him he is alone in the third one.
I can't do this, Pete.
Peter then returns home and finds Klimke and his girlfriend Beato waiting for him at his home. Klimke and Peter put Anna to bed when he revealed that he did not want to have them because he was always afraid of losing them. After that, they have dinner together, and when Klimke leaves, Detective Edwards spots Klimke and Peter together. The next day, Peter and Sophia send Anna with her friend while creating a fake domestic violence scenario, and Peter ends up in jail. The jailer, Sluit, welcomes him. Sluit leads him to the bed among the rival gang members, but then the general's men approach him and buy two beds beside Peter. Wattek members assure him that they will treat him like a brother. The next day, Peter meets Wattek members inside the jail and gets a knife while observing the rival gang members. After that, when Keith comes to see her, Erica is at her office, but he finds Edward with her. Edward introduces himself,
Detective Edward Grants from the NYPD,
reveals that he is looking for Peter, and reveals how he was freed from jail. Edward tries to get rid of him, but Edward shows them the evidence of Erica walking away from the crime scene immediately after Daniel was murdered. At night, Sophia hides the drugs inside a dead pigeon, and Stasek throws the dead pigeon on the jail's roof using a drone. Peter finds the pigeon and collects it from the roof while working. In the meantime, Edward sees Sophia and tells her he can help them. Sophia gets emotional and replies that since Peter killed the man in the bar for misbehaving with her, nothing has been the same for them, and whoever approached them intending to help has done the opposite. Edward drops his card and leaves. Peter is with his friends the next day when a man named Vermin comes to see him and makes him listen to a phone call. Peter talks to the phone, and it appears to be Edward on call, who calls himself Hangman and tells Peter that he needs information about Daniel's murders.
You ready to talk about Officer Gomez's murder?
And adds that Vermin is his only way out. The next day, Erica is summoned by Keith, and he informs her that Edward went to jail and that soon they will not be able to keep him away from Peter. He adds that he has contacted NYPD and questioned why they are trying to protect an informant who must not exist. Erica is confused, but then Keith orders her to burn Peter, meaning to let him be inside the jail for the rest of his life. Erica is shocked and claims they have promised Peter and can't do this to him, but Keith does not care and leaves, warning her that he will put everything on her otherwise. After that, Sluit leads Peter to a secluded room where the rival gang members are waiting for him. They order Sluit to beat Peter, after which he leaves. The gang members hang Peter, and before he may die, he admits he is a snitch working to bring down the general.
I made a deal with the feds to take down the general.
He tells them that he needs the names of all his suppliers and that he will destroy Klimke. The gang leader tells him he will get the information if he is found alive after 3 hours. After the given time ends, a man gives the name to Peter. And when he approaches Leinart with the list, he tells him that he has been ordered not to let him outside the jail. Peter gets confused, and upon contacting Erica, he learns he has been trapped. He contacts Sophia and orders her to give all Erica and Keith's audio recordings to Edward, after he discovers that he has promised them help. Erica meets the lawyer of Klemek's men inside the jail and reveals Peter's identity, after which he provides the information to the gang. In the meantime, Sophia tries to get the tapes, but Erica stops her and takes the tape, revealing that they have heard their conversation.
We heard everything. We tracked you here.
Peter returns to his bed, but Man tells him his cover has been blown, so he gets ready to fight. Soon, a man attacks him, but Peter knocks him out after a little struggle. Unfortunately, he draws the guard's attention, and as Sluit tries to approach him, Peter holds him hostage by passing a scissor in his ear. He demands to talk to his wife in a press conference in return for letting Sluit go alive. Peter reaches a safe place and starts thinking about what to do next after he knocks out Sluit. On the other hand, Stasik approaches to kill Sophia and Anna as they break into their house. Sophia contacts Edward, but she gets caught before she tells him anything. Erica contacts Keith and learns he has been given full authority to deal with Peter.
Anything is granted me as authority.
And that he knows what Peter is doing. Edward does not feel right, and upon reaching Peter's house, he finds a polished man inside and shoots him. But Stasik traps him and injures him badly. Before Stasik can kill Edward, Sophia shoots at him and gets shot in return. Edward then kills him with a gun. The FBI surrounds the jail within a short time, and when Peter is done setting things up according to his plan, he contacts Sophia and learns that they are fine. Peter talks to his daughter and claims to love her.
Daddy loves you very much.
But the FBI disconnects the call. As the snipers take their positions, Peter switches disguises with Sluit and forces him to attack. As Sluit tries to choke him, Peter brings him in front of snipers, and they shoot Sluit. Peter then hides before the gas cylinders blast. Erica arrives at the crime scene and is thrilled to see the blast. Keith orders his men to confirm that the survivor's ID says Sluit. As Peter is taken to the ambulance, Erica recognizes him and gets on the bus. She finds Peter in his senses and passes her gun to him, after which Peter cuffs all the medics and leaves after getting an address from Erica and ordering her to cuff herself too. After a few days, Erica sees Keith, and when he orders her to kill Peter, because she knows his address, Erica refuses to do so.
I can't.
Keith gets mad at her, and before he can leave, Edward and a few other NYPD officers arrest him for doing everything wrong. Following that, Sophia and Anna are with Erica in a park, and Peter looks at them from a safe distance. Suddenly, Edward reaches him and tells him that Erica wants him to stay away from his family for some more time as she cannot take them off. Peter is advised to stay low for longer, and the movie ends when Peter walks away. And that's the end of this recap. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button for more. Thanks for watching, and see you at the next one.